Now that you guys know the funny way to memorize which halogens are going to be more selective and which ones are less selective, now I want to teach you just really quickly the rigorous actual reason why bromine is so much more selective than chlorination. And it doesn't really technically have to do with how exothermic it is. In fact, it has to do with the Hammond postulate, okay? So remember what we learned about Hammond postulate? It is a way that describes what transition states look like. And the Hammond postulate is really the reason why bromination is so much more selective than chlorination. So let me show you guys that now. Okay, so once again, my definition of selectivity hasn't changed, but it turns out that I'm going to use the Hammond postulate to explain why bromination is so much more selective. So first of all, I just want to show you the reaction diagram for, or the energy diagram for radical chlorination. Let's go ahead and look at the x-axis first and just look at the coordinates. Notice that all of these things should look familiar. Basically, this is the first step of my propagation phase. Okay, so this is all propagation here. I'm just gonna put prop, okay? So I got my propagation phase. We would expect that that takes energy because you're breaking a bond, right? So that's gonna be this, basically this activation energy here, okay? That's gonna be the activation energy required to do that first step, okay? Then what that's gonna make is an intermediate that looks like that, okay? That's a radical, that's my intermediate. And notice that here I put rate determining step. Remember that your slow step, the one that makes the intermediate, is always gonna be your rate determining step. Does that make sense so far? Cool. So then what happens is that in the next part of my reaction diagram, there's like a story. Then what happens? Well, remember my propagation phase isn't done yet. I need to react my, well, in this case, this would be a termination step here. So let me just say here, this will be termination. Okay, and in my termination step, what I get is now two radicals colliding to make a new single bond. Now, just so you guys know, technically this might come up conceptually, the activation energy for two radicals to collide and make a new bond is always gonna be exactly zero. This is just a definition that you guys should know, that the activation energy of two radicals colliding is always zero. It doesn't take energy for that to happen. So that's why there is actually no hump here, okay? Usually we would expect to see two humps, but there's no hump there because it doesn't take any energy for that to happen, okay? Now notice here that my overall enthalpy at the end is -101, like I told you guys. But what's really important that I want you guys to note is what the transition state looks like, okay? Now I'm not gonna go through this just yet. I'm just gonna let you guys know, pay attention to what that transition state looks like. Hammond's postulate, and now we're going to look at bromination and see how bromination is different.